Before we get started, I just want to first say that this is not a beginner's Laravel course. You are welcome to follow along if you want. However, you really should have some kind of foundation in Laravel before starting this course. So with that being said, the first thing that I want to do is whip up a Laravel project. So since I have it installed globally, I'm just going to do Laravel new API. Okay, and now that that's done, let's go ahead and head over to the .env file and start making sure our setup is okay. So the first thing I want to do is change the app name to Coder's Conduct. And then I also want to set up our database. I already have it set up, so I'm just going to add it here. So mine is Coder's Conduct, and username is root, password is blank. And now we can do PHP, or we need to CD into the API folder. That's this folder right here. And now we can do PHP artisan migrate. And let's just go ahead and start the server and make sure that we're getting it. So PHP artisan serve. Okay, and let's check the browser. Okay, and we have a basic Laravel installation. There's no authentication set up yet, but we have it. So now let's go ahead and stop the server and open this up. So the first thing that I want to do is install Fortify. So we'll head over to the documentation. We'll go down to installation. And the first command we need to run is composer require Laravel Fortify. And again, make sure you're in the API folder to install these Laravel packages. Okay, great. So the next command we need to run is the PHP artisan vendor publish to publish all of the vendor files that we need. Back, paste that in. Okay, and now we head back to the documentation and get ready for the next step, which is PHP artisan migrate. And we need to run these because we need these two-factor authentication fields in our database. Okay, and while that's doing that, we need to make sure that in our config app.php file that we have this class listed in our list of providers. Okay, and that's right in config app.php. Okay, and you scroll down to the service providers. We can just go ahead and paste it here. And then we need to make sure to add class, comma. And now on to the next part, which is in the config fortify, these are the features that it's recommending we use. We're going to be using all of them, but we're also going to be using some others. Fortify.php. Right in here, we'll just comment all of these out and we'll work on them one at a time. We'll start with the registration a bit later, but we'll just set it up like this for now. The other thing we need to do is make sure that the views are false since we'll be using Nuxt on the front end. We won't be using the Laravel routes. The next thing we need to do is, yep, views false. Okay, and that's pretty much it, and we will come back to all the rest of this later. The next thing I want to do is set up our Laravel Sanctum. So Sanctum has two ways of being set up. One is for API token authentication, and one is for SPA authentication. So one is using tokens, and the other is using cookies. Now, if we were setting this up with Jetstream and Inertia, it would use the API token authentication. But because we're using an SPA, which is separate, it's not within the Laravel app, we're going to be using the SPA authentication. Okay, and that'll be using the cookie-based system. Let's come down here. Well, we need to install it first. Composer require Laravel Sanctum. We'll paste that in, let that run. And then we're also going to run this PHP artisan vendor. We're going to publish the service provider for it. Let me go ahead and open that up. Okay, and now we can go ahead and paste that. Okay, and now let's head back to the documentation. And we don't have to run this, but I'm going to run it anyway, just in case we might need it. So now it's saying that if you plan to utilize Sanctum to authenticate an SPA, which we are doing, you should add Sanctum's middleware to your API middleware group within your application's kernel file. So let's grab this line of code right here. And then we're going to go to this kernel file. Close this up. We're going to open up app, HTTP, kernel. And then right in here under the API, we're going to go ahead and paste that in. And because we're using the whole namespace, we don't have to import anything. We can just leave that the way it is. Fantastic. Let's head back to the documentation. Scroll down a bit. We're not customizing the migration. Okay. API token authentication. And because we're not using the token method, we don't have to add this to our user model. If we were using Jetstream, that would need to be in there, but we'd not. Go down. First party UI. Routes. So this is the middleware that we now need to add to our API file. We'll come over here. We'll go to routes, api.php. And now on here, we can go ahead and just paste that in. The next thing we need to do is for our SPA authentication. Let's see. We've already added the middleware, cores, and cookies. In the cores config, we need to make sure that our supports credentials is set to true. Let's go ahead and do that. Config, cores, supports credentials. We'll set that to true. And this file is important because all of the calls that we'll be making to our Laravel backend have to go through here, and they need to be approved from Laravel in order to be able to send those requests. So any of the routes that we need are going to go in here. This API slash asterisk is basically saying anything in this API file is part of what's going to be approved based on the configuration that we set up. And so is the Sanctum CSRF cookie, which is a call we need to make whenever we need to authenticate a user. We can close this, and we can close this. So now back to the documentation. It says, in addition, you should enable the with credentials. This is something we are going to set up on Nuxt in order to be able to make those Axios calls to our backend. So we'll set that up in a bit. But finally, you should ensure your application's session cookie domain configuration supports any subdomain of your root domain. That's a lot of mumbo jumbo. Let's just take a look. Let's go to our session.php config file and see what we're looking at. So session.php. Now, if you scroll down to where it says session cookie domain, you see that we have a key here for domain. It's in our environment variable under session domain. But if you take a look at our .env file, we don't actually have that. So that's something that we need to put in. We'll put it under the session lifetime. This session domain, but we'll put it in caps, session domain is going to equal localhost. So all this is saying is that Laravel on the back end, Nuxt on the front end, they are part of the same app and they share the domain name of localhost. That's why we're putting this in here like that. The next thing we need to do is also add our domain name for Nuxt. So if we go to the Sanctum config, you'll see under here stateful, what they're looking for is the Sanctum stateful domain. Okay, so let's copy that in and we're going to specify it in that environment variable .env. We're going to add it right under here. And then we're going to say Sanctum stateful domains equals localhost because we're sharing it, but we are going to be using 3000 as the server port. This is for Nuxt. This is for Nuxt and Laravel. Now we need to also add the URL for our app URL. So this one will be just for Laravel. That means now instead of whatever this is here, we're going to change this to localhost 8000 because that's the port that Laravel is using. Fantastic. So now that all of that is set up, we can close out of all of these and start setting up our Nuxt app. So I'll open up another terminal and we'll slide that over a little bit and then we'll head over to the Nuxt documentation. If we scroll down to the bottom part, we can go to npm init Nuxt latest. This is what I'm using. You can also use npx, or if you're using Yarn, you can also use Yarn to do the same thing. Now you want to make sure that you are in the coder's conduct folder, meaning the main folder that's housing both of these, because now we're going to have API and we're also going to have client for the Nuxt front end. Okay, so let's paste that in. And then we're also going to add to it our front end project name, which we're going to call client. I'm going to press enter and let that run. Let me open this up a bit. And now we're going to have a series of questions we need to answer. So the project name, we're just going to keep it as client. Enter. Programming language, we're using JavaScript. And enter is to select it. And then the up down arrow is what chooses it. JavaScript package manager, we're going to be using NPM. UI framework, we're going to use Tailwind. Nuxt modules, we do need Axios. To select it from here, you want to use the spacebar, and that's all we're going to need from there. ESLint, no, just press enter. Testing framework, none. Universal, yes. Server Node.js, yes. And then we're going to select jsconfig.json for this. What is your GitHub? No. Version control, none. I am going to be using GitHub, but it's going to house both the front end and the back end, so I don't need that. And we'll just let that run. Now that's going to take a while, so we'll let that do that. Okay, now that that's done, we can go ahead and cd into that folder, which is client. And then we'll run npm run dev. Cool. So now we have our environment running on localhost 3000. We'll take this. And we'll paste that in here. Now you could also, I think it's alt click. Yeah, alt click, and that would have done the same thing. But for now we have this. Okay, very cool. So this looks like it's new. We recommend you take a look at the documentation, and to get started, remove component tutorial and start coding in pages index. So let's go ahead and do that since we're not going to need that page. We're going to go to client, components, and we can just go ahead and get rid of it. We'll just delete. And head down to pages, and right in the index.view, we can go ahead and get rid of the component from here. So we'll do h1. And here we'll just say hi from Nuxt, just so that we can make sure that we're getting it. Let's head back to the browser. And as you can see, it's hot reloading for us. Okay, and there we have our hi from Nuxt. Fantastic. So we've got it set up. So now the other thing we also need to do is add our auth Nuxt, the auth module for the Nuxt. If we head over to that documentation, we need to use, we're going to be using NPM, or I'm going to be using NPM. So I'll just copy this. And we already have Axios, so we don't need that. But now we can go ahead and stop the server. We'll do npm install and let that install for us. Now the next step in here is we need to add this to our Nuxt config. This is the one we need. We'll copy it. And in our Nuxt config, we'll scroll down to our modules. And as you can see, we already have Nuxt Axios in here, so we'll just paste it underneath. Now the next thing we need to do is to set up our provider. Okay, and because we're using Sanctum, we're just going to use this as a strategy. So basically, let's just go ahead and copy this auth, and we can put it under the modules. Again, all this is saying that the strategy we're choosing, put a comma, is the Laravel Sanctum strategy. The provider is Laravel Sanctum, and then the URL is going to be our localhost. So we'll do HTTP localhost 8000. And this will be the prefix for all of the calls that we're sending to the backend. Let's check through here. And we also need to add the Axios, but we're going to do it slightly differently. Let's set up our Axios. Come down here. And before I do that, I actually want to change the spacing because we're on two spaces for the tab. And I just want to change that to 4. Nothing really specific to the project. It's just my personal preference to have the indentation at 4. So now for Axios, we're going to have the base URL is going to be HTTP localhost 8000 down here. And now we need to have our credentials set to true. And if you remember, that's what we were supposed to set up when we were setting up our Sanctum, is that it wanted us to, the defaults with credentials, it's the same thing as doing it like this in here. Great. So now, in the strategy, we need to set up some endpoints. So right under the URL, we're going to set up our endpoints. So the first one is going to be login. The next one is going to be logout. And the last one is going to be user. And these endpoints are what's being sent to the API, routes.api. So all of the calls coming from here are what we are calling in here for our authentication. So the first route, the login route, we're going to say the URL for that is going to be API login or logout. It's going to be API logout. And for the user, it's going to be API user. Now, under these endpoints, we also need to specify a key here. So user property is false. Again, this is all in the documentation, which I will add to the description down below. I'll add the link for it, but it's basically all in here. So you can take a look at it and go through it and see what else you might need. Fantastic. So for now, all I want to do is to run PHP artisan serve and then npm run dev, and then we'll work on the landing page. First things first, we'll go to the pages folder right in the index. And let's see, the error is the Vuex store is not activated. Because in store, we need to have an index.js file. And so the only thing we need to do in here is create a new file and call it index.js. And we don't need to put anything in there. We just need to make sure it's in there. Okay, and now it starts for us. Now we can close this. And now we can close this and this as well. In our pages index file, I'm going to put a div with the classes of bg, cover, min, height, screen, and we'll leave it at that for now. I also want to add in that background image. So style equals, I'll just paste it in. This image is just an unsplash image, so you have it in here. And let's just make sure that we're getting it. So we'll go to the browser and we'll just check. Great. So now all I want to do at this point is paste in a bunch of code. And let's see. Okay, and all this is the welcome to Coder's Conduct text. And we have a register link, a login link. And they don't go anywhere yet because we don't have those pages. And now we also have the link for attribution, because you always want to give credit where credit is due. So we're going to have the link with the attribution for the unsplash image that we're using. And now let's go back. Now we see it here. We have hover text and then we have the link to the unsplash. Fantastic. I'm going to leave it there for now. I'll make sure to push all of this code up to GitHub, and I'll leave a link for that down in the description. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.